What? Eh? So, I guess it was closer to 5 minutes. I was like, oh shoot, I should go to the bathroom before I settle into stream. So anyway, usually I'm pretty good at starting 3 minutes in, but this time it was 5. Anyway, yeah, I mean a bit tired today, a bit out of it. What do I have a moon? It looks like someone gifted you a sub. Yeah, I had a couple people gifting subs recently, and looks like they sniped you. They got you. Pow pow. yeah. Anyways, I had a rough time falling asleep last night. I didn't fall asleep until like 5:30, 6 in the morning. I slept in super late today to make up for it, which is also why I'm kind of late, but I'm also a little out of it right now, super tired. So we're gonna do kind of like a chill, low energy stream today. And that's kind of what game or playthroughs are meant to be for me, just kind of chill, hang out kind of streams. But it'll be especially chill today because I'm quite sleepy. but I did it. I committed myself to 3 streams this week. I got the 3 streams. And I think next week I might just do 2. Might just take a breather. And that way I can also squeeze in.
Yes, I am first. You all shall bow before my greatness.
Nice job getting first. Congrats. But yeah, I think I'll do 2 streams next week. Probably still some more Paper Mario. I was here first. What do you mean? you gotta claim first in the channel point redemptions. That's funny. Yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and hop into the game. I wanna be on the left. That's kind of funny. I guess technically you have like the bragging rights of being here first person in chat. But there's also the channel point redemption to claim first. You gotta be kind of slick in order to get it, I guess. you can already tell my brain's just like, it's dead from the get-go for this stream. Yeah, this is what you can expect for today. This A-plus commentary. Alright, anyways, so where we left off, we are on the XS Express, and we are headed to... I knew the name, anyways, we're headed to a posh town, area, I can't remember the name of it, and, we have a little bit of a mystery on our hands. Things have been going missing. Last episode we ran into a ghost, and the ghost killed us. So that's fine. And right now you can kind of hear in the music. Actually, I'll get out of the menu so you can hear it better. Waiting for it. You can hear some squeaking. And I'm assuming that with items going missing, our illustrious thief might be Miss Mouse. We might be running into Miss Mouse again. So let's see if we can go into the back rooms of the train. see if our little friend over here is gonna let us in. And yeah. I don't know if I can do Toad voice today. I can do a little bit of voices, but I am super out of it today, so maybe like as I get more into the stream, I'll wake up a bit more, but we'll see.
Hello, Detective Mario. I saw no one suspicious during the night. We will be stopping at Riverside Station today, around dusk, I believe.
Okay, that's it, so he won't let us in. So we're not going back there yet. Do you guys have anything new to say? Top of the morning to you, Gonzales. Top of the morning to you, laddies. Sorry. I'm gonna crack open my Pepsi here. Maybe get a bit of caffeine. Is there even caffeine in this? Oh, a bit of sugar anyway. I'm afraid you saw us at our arguing worst yesterday. I feel rather ashamed. Little Bub here sure has been in high spirits since yesterday. I wonder why he's so happy.
Good morning, mister. Thanks for the autograph yesterday.
We'll do a subtle nod to voices, but I am... oh, so out of it today. I don't know how I'm gonna get through it, but we'll see.
There's but one option, Luigi. You must find that thief.
We must apprehend the suspect before the dastardly plan is put into effect. The voices will also slowly come back to me, I guess.
Oh no, not good, not good. If I don't find that thing, I'll be sacked for sure.
Has this been a coherent enough of an opening for you guys? Long story short, me sleepy.
Hello, it is a good feeling day, isn't it, friend of mine? Yes, a delicious day.
I will make food so delicious, it will make that day mad. Hoi, 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 hoi. Is good? Yeah, okay. This is basically like my Friday. Like, Thursdays are like my Fridays. So you know what I mean when I say it's like, it's a Friday.
Good morning! Is there any chance you've seen my shell earrings anywhere?
We haven't found her earrings yet, and we're also looking for a ring. It's coming back to me a bit more. Don't ask me why I'm saving more than usual. I just feel the urge every time I see a save block to hit it. Because this is quite literally a line up and down. I'm probably going to just be saving a lot.
Hey, morning. I don't know how to do a deep Toad voice anymore.
Morning, Mario. Have you been to the dining car yet today? I still can't believe I stole that pot of stew. It was like a bad chowdery nightmare. But thanks to that incident, the cook and I are pals now. Isn't life weird? Well, hello there, you cute cuddly bear, man you. You're delightful, dear. Have you found my gold ring? Don't grow desperate now. I'm quite sure you'll be able to find it.
That's it. That's the best Toad voice I got for today. I might not keep it up. Oh, letter. You got a vital paper. This looks like something very important and complicated. All right, bet. Hey, I'm a little late. Was listening to music. No worries. All you really missed was my super all over the place, goofy intro. Long story short, I'm sleepy. Brain is like, we're starting off with a brain that's not working today, as opposed to getting like an hour and a half in and then it stops working. So, sound gallery. What? Okay, this is not important right now. Let's not get distracted. Alright, good to know. That's my disclaimer for today. Gear. Useful items. Whoa. Okay. This looks like something very important and complicated. Oh, you can't, like, read it. Okay. Gotcha. Poshley Heights. I was almost correct when I said we were going somewhere posh. I assume the conductor or the engineer. Good morning to you, sir. Did you sleep well? Yeah, I can't do like intense voices today. I'm very sleepy. I did not fall asleep until like 6 a.m. It was kind of brutal. We will be making a stop at Riverside Station today. You'll love it, I assure you. Okay. Whee! Don't worry, it's quite sad you can't do today's voice. Our voices today. Yeah. They're fun to do, but I am super sleepy today, so we're kind of just gonna vibe for a bit. Enjoy the story, I think. Take it easy tonight. Yes. But I warned you, I said it. I said hydrate, eat, sleep. Yes. Yeah, I just had kind of a busy day. Not too busy yesterday, but busy enough that by the time bedtime came around, I couldn't like shut off my brain. So it was tricky trying to fall asleep. Have you stumbled upon any new clues? Vital paper. What is this paper? What sort of clue is this supposed to be?
That's one of the contracts for my upcoming business deal.
What? I mean, yes, just as I suspected. Luigi, where did you find this very important clue? It's fine, don't worry, sometimes sleeping is difficult. Yeah, I've been trying to get better at it, but insomnia really, like, snuck up on me last night and went, "You're coming down with me. I'm dragging you down." Cabin one, you say? Yes. Ziptoad's room. A place I have long suspected. Come to think of it, I do not believe I've seen him today. And then perhaps he is hiding somewhere on the train, always one step ahead. Very well, my dear Luigi. Find that Ziptoad. I had such a busy day, too. Just laying in bed listening to you seem very busy. I mean, sometimes there's, like, physically busy, and then there's, like, mentally busy. Sleeping is my favorite hobby. I agree. Oh, we're looking for Ziptoad.
Another paper!
Could this be another clue?
This paper is just like the last one. The suspect must be in here somewhere.
Can I not pick it up? Oh. Gosh, you got that right. I was mentally busy. I was writing down my life, my trauma, my experiences. That's kind of a mood, though. I haven't, like, vented into a journal in a while. kind of like haven't had the time.
Zell, where'd you come from? You won't be catching me that easily, guy.
Oh yeah? Got him.
Ouch!
I can do a little bit of voices. A little bit of voices. Not too much, though.
So this was our man all along, pretending to be Ziptoad, I see. All the while pilfering things from others to aid your evil plan. Yes, this was all just as I had deduced. I knew all along you were a fake. Yes, a discolored nostril hair tipped me off.
It was a moody.
And not only that, but I knew that you were the one who threatened Luigi.
Curses. I almost got away with it by getting off at Riverside Station, too.
Writing down my traumas while listening to music, that honestly sounds... Not, I don't want to say, like, nice, because it's not, like, in a good way sometimes. But it does seem like a just... what's the word I'm looking for? Cathartic, I think is the word. It sounds cathartic.
Yes, you played a daring and ingenious little game, my false friend. But the jig is up now, fiend, and the good people on this train are now safe. For, indubitably, no one escapes from this improbably large brain. Well, yes, in any case, at least return what you have stolen, Fink.
Blech. I got a briefcase!
A heavy briefcase with nitro honey syrup and documents inside. Why would that be given to me, though, and not to the guy who owns it? Oh, I'm getting all the items. Oh, okay. I see. I love the description. Earrings lost by the waitress. They remind her of her ex. I don't know why that was funny. That just, I forgot about that whole thing. Writing down my translation music, but gosh. When you give me something to write about, I'm writing a book because, like, I don't stop writing, honestly. Yeah. I used to be like that. I could just, like, write and write and write. And eventually I found it hard to get, like, I was the type of person who found it really hard to meet word counts in school. Because I like everything to be kind of right to the point. But if I sit and, like, talk about something, I could just ramble about it for days. But when it comes down to writing it down, I don't know why. I love writing, but I feel like I get a whole bunch more ideas out better when I'm just, like, talking. So, I've actually started recording my rambles and ideas, and then I'll take, my phone can, like, take what I say and convert it to text, and then I'll copy that text and put it into a document. It's actually been so helpful.
My precious briefcase! Is the nitro honey syrup safe? There you go.
The briefcase was returned.
Oh, thank you, thank you! Thank the stars, it's safe! Now I won't get the sack!
A rendezvous with disaster was diffused by my most rudimentary of deductions.
Okay, buddy.
Attention, all passengers! This train will soon make a brief scheduled stop at Riverside Station.
I could never talk about my traumas in person. I don't trust no one who I speak with in person. I mean, that's fair. Yeah, when I, like, ramble about stuff, it's usually about, like, shows that I like or something. But also, I used to have a therapist that I would go to when I was younger. And I did find it always helped to be able to speak about things out loud. But, you know, to each their own. Writing it down is nice and neat, keeps my thoughts organized and well kept. Yeah, I totally agree. And I find that writing stuff down, too, prevents you from, like, overthinking about it, or at least for me. Because then it's kind of like once you get it out of your head and down on paper, it's like you don't have to force yourself to remember it anymore. I don't know if that makes sense, but it does help to just release things.
Hey, I think not, Slick. You think you can hold me? No way. Meldam would flip if I let that happen.
I completely forgot about this. I could always go back to it. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You can always go back to it if you need to. But you don't have to carry it with you anymore because you kind of just let it out. Yeah.
This whole Ziptoad thing was just a means to an end. It's me, suckers. Dupless. Beldam's plan to gooify Mario didn't exactly work, so I'll be cutting and running now. I'll leave the rest to Beldam. See ya, suckers.
That would actually be such an easy cosplay to do.
Wanna get outside for a second? The exit is in the first car.
Hell yeah.
Oh, read what do I remember and then cry. Just kidding, I don't cry from my traumas, but just thinking about it in whatever mood I'm in. I used to be pretty, like, pretty good at just sort of stealing myself. I try to cry more often now, though, because sometimes you just need that release of energy. but usually when I feel that way, I'm like, I'll watch something sad just to, like, let it... I don't know. It's weird. Actually, you know, I think it's the opposite. When I was a kid, I would just cry and vent everything and let it all out. But now as I've gotten older, I found it's, like, harder to do that, and I just don't know why. Anyway, but yeah, crying is fine. Crying is a good thing. I think it's good to just let out your emotions if you can, if you want to. That's a personal thing, though. So it's different for everybody.
It's so super cool looking. I want to drive it right now.
I can't remember what voice I did for him or how I did his voice.
So little bub really likes trains, does he? Where does one buy a train?
I know that's not it, but it'll come back to me eventually.
Oh no, what'll we do? Someone's lifted the drawbridge. This train can't leave the station like this. I saw some suspicious looking shadowy people wearing hats go into the station. They must have gone down the bridge control room to flip the switch there. But that switch hasn't been used in so long, I don't know where the control room is. So, it's probably against protocol to ask a passenger to do this, but since you are the famous Mario and all, could you go find and throw that switch? Maybe. Sure thing.
My traumas aren't that bad that I cry about it. Maybe sometimes. Most of the time it's like it plays in my mind mostly, so IRL. It's not that big, but I just make it bigger in my head. I actually totally get that. There's a lot of, like, I used to, I don't do it as much now because I've been working on myself a lot, but I used to, even like as recent as like a year or two ago, I would look back on things that I did and I would cringe and I would feel so embarrassed. And then I started to realize that, like, most people in those scenarios, they don't remember it. I'm like the only one who does. And eventually I learned to just start letting it go and not obsess over it too much, but it can take a while to get to that point.
No time to get started like the present. So here's the station's entrance key.
I love that he's trusting me with a key to this building. I love the logic in these games. It's so good.
Oh, thank you so much. I'd be cooped up in there breathing stale air for too long. I wanted to go out and take a walk so I could build up an appetite for dinner.
Hey, kiddo. You need something from the old battle master?
Oh yeah, I forgot that's who you are. I'm good. I'm happy with how I've been battling. My dear Luigi. Our suspect was not only a fake sip toad. He was some monstrous being in a white sheet, which was exactly as I suspected. Too bad he gave us the slip like that, though. He was a rather slippery sort. We could have questioned him about all of that Beldam business.
This is Riverside Station. We've stopped to refuel. There's a quaint drawbridge here from when pleasure boats cruised the canal. But it hasn't been used since the canal was dried up and turned to pasture.
Interesting. He shouldn't have trusted you yet. It's a little weird. Does that mean everybody else is still on the train? Can I, like, return the items before I go in? Because I kind of want to return the items. Okay, this is where Duplis was. There's the other toad.
Have you found my gold ring, you mystery sniffing master?
Here you go. It's a massive ring. It's like the size of your head.
Yes, that's definitely the ring I lost. Thank you, you glorious creature. I knew you would find it without fail. It is merely a trifle, but please take this as my earnest thanks.
Nice.
And do take care.
That's funny. Seductive toad voice. Anyway. Nothing here. Oh no, the waitress is gonna be in the food cart, right? And then this is our room. I don't know, but I like writing mainly about my life since a lot of trauma, but it's very relaxing, just like drawing to me. Yeah, I totally get that.
Welcome, welcome. Oh, did you find them, my shell earrings? Oh, there they are. They're my earrings. These are my earrings. Thank you so much. Hey, and before I forget, take this as my thanks. Yay. You are like the nicest old mustached overwall wearing guy I've ever met.
All right. I love writing as well. I really should get back into the habit of journaling more. But one thing I used to do, especially in high school, is I would write a lot of fiction, and that's how I would vent. Feels like a sigh of relief as I write it out of my mind for a little bit. Yeah, yeah, that's good. Yeah, I feel like everyone needs like a good way to like vent out your feelings, and writing is probably one of the best ways, in my opinion. Really, because it doesn't hurt you, doesn't hurt anyone else, and yeah, writing is also like a really useful skill, so it's like a win all around. See, I don't need a therapist, I just need a notebook with a lock on it. Yeah, I feel that. I would love to. So right now where I live, we have a bit of a crisis where there's not really any therapists available. They're pretty busy, and they're also, they can be pretty expensive, especially if you're someone like me who's self-employed and doesn't really have, like, insurance. But my goal is for next year to get myself, like, onto an insurance program and then eventually get back into, like, I'd love to go and talk to someone again for a little bit, because it does help me.
I love therapy. I pretty much did it right up until I was 19 or 20. And then I was in this little program for a bit where I got to speak to a therapist again for a bit. And right now I'm kind of at this moment in time where I feel like I don't need to constantly visit a therapist, but it would be nice to talk to someone every once in a while. So yeah, I would love to do that again someday. obviously it's not for everybody. Not everyone likes to sit and like talk with a stranger for an hour. And if journaling is what works for you, then hell yeah, keep doing it. But yeah, I probably ain't never gonna get a therapist, to be honest. My trust issues and stuff. Yeah, exactly. If it doesn't work for you, it doesn't work for you, and that's totally fine. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. Just because it works for me does not mean it works for everybody. But for me personally, like, I would love to, have the ability to do, like, I don't know, a session every 4 months or something, or we'll see, like, something like that might help. Because I find that when I talk things, like, say it out loud, I work through stuff a lot better. But again, that's probably just, like, that could be just me. Everyone got their own ways, and that's fine. Exactly. Is this gonna hit anybody or is it just gonna hit him? Okay, it's just gonna hit him. Or them. I don't know. I default to he, him pronouns for most things. Yeah. I've been trying to default to they, them more often, though. Tattle. Like, for me, when I talk in person about, like, anything bad that happened, I get shaky and then just shut off. Yeah, like, sometimes it can do more harm than good, you know? But as long as you have, like, obviously, like you said, you have writing. I feel like as long as someone can find a way to vent things out, it doesn't really matter how they do it, as long as it's not, like, putting themselves or someone else in danger. That's just kind of my take on just about anything. It's like, enjoy what you like and do what works for you, as long as it's not hurting anybody, you know? But yeah. this is a rough puff. Don't confuse them with dark puffs. Although I don't think the world would end if you did confuse them, but anyway. Max HP is 7, attack is 4, and defense is 0. They swoop at you or charge themselves with electricity before unleashing lightning. Oh, and if you touch them while they're charged, you'll get a shock. And they'll absorb any lightning attacks you throw their way, so don't do that. Yeah, you get it. Want to scratch my nose and, ooh, ow. And then I was like, I have to dodge or defend. Okay. Can I jump on them right now? I totally missed it. I think it's only when they're charged you can't jump on them. Yeah, so you can jump on them now. It's fine. Writing without my music, it's a no. Ain't no way I'm writing without music. Honestly, that might be my issue right now, is when I go to journal, I don't have anything else going on, so I kind of get, like, bored, and I don't really have any, maybe I just need music to, like, stimulate thoughts better. Rally wink. Wink at Mario to give him the courage for an extra action. Wait, that's funny. I think we're just gonna do a regular head bonk. Oh, yeah. That does 6 damage. That's pretty decent. Uh-oh. We can no longer touch him. Touch them. Sorry. Is there something else we can do, though? I can't use Thunder Rage. I guess we'll find out what Mystery does. Okay. I think we just lucked out. We just got possibly one of the best things we could have gotten there. Honestly, the fact that I write a whole book just for some of my traumas is quite concerning. I mean, honestly, I'm no professional. I can't say anything, but I think the fact that you take the time to write it, and you just kind of go for it, you let it all out instead of only partially letting out, I think it's a good sign. I don't know. I don't know, though. I wouldn't be too worried about how much you write. I think as long as you're getting it out there, nothing wrong with that. Yeah. Also, kind of relatable. I don't know if I'll ever publish it, but I've actually been legitimately writing a draft of a book for my own stuff. Because I've found it's been very, very helpful, I guess, to work through things, so. Oh, jumped one too far. No, that's, yeah, I get that. It's totally relatable. Okay. Okay, so I see. It's gonna go like one, two, three. Oh, I missed! Damn it. But I think I see it now. I think I see it. Okay. And one, two, three, four, five, six. Bam! Hell yeah. Okay. The mood that I'm in when writing, my mood depends on the music a lot, so I was in quite a sassy mood. So reading it is so funny, honestly nice. It sounds kinda fun actually, just to write and be a little sassy. I kind of want to try it, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, yeah, okay. And then I think we need Coops. It was fun. It actually sounds kind of like a good vibe. I want to try it. I might. I'll try it and then I'll report back and see how it goes. All right. We got the key. That was it for those stairs, I think. Can I read these at all? No. Okay. I've had, just 21 Pilots stuck in my head for so long. Obviously because I went to the concert, but it's just been like continuously living rent-free in my head. So maybe I'll put on some 21 Pilots and then try writing and see what happens. As you probably guessed, it's a poisonous pokey. Max HP is 8, attack is 4, and defense is 0. If you get poisoned, your HP will slowly drain, so you may want to avoid that. I'm sure you can see this, but they have spines all over, so don't touch them. They may be smiling, but that doesn't mean they're happy to see you. Damn. Ouchie. Ooh, okay. Okay, that was a little concerning. We're good, we're good. Okay. I was having flashbacks at the last time I walked up to, one of these guys that have spikes on the side and it's still hurting me. I wrote it kind of like, so this B, blah, blah, blah. I was so F stupid. Aw. kind of feels cathartic though, not gonna lie. Yeah, something I gotta try, I think. Ooh. An HP drain. Quite fun though. I was being very real with it. Yeah. No, it sounds like a good like release of pent up energy. You know what I mean? All right. Let's see. Let's see if I can do this. Let's see how tired I really am. If I can still do this, then we might be okay. Let's go. When the music's great, I'm great. Yeah. Nothing wrong with a good vibe. Nice. Ooh. This is fine. Yeah, we got this. We're good. Yeah. There we go. Oh, got him. The amount of the amount of concentration I'm using right now, not to just get totally lost in the music. Yeah, I caught it. I caught the Pokemon. Let's go. You got it. Yeah, let's go. My brain is so cooked, y'all. I'm gonna just sleep in so much more, I think. Well, that's I think the first time I've missed my I've missed the stylish thing. I want to. I want to do that, and then I want to do this again. Brain where exactly? Literally though. Brain, we don't know her. Yeah, so next week I'm thinking I'll probably stream twice. If I have a really good sleep, I might be able to get away with three times. But I'm gonna take it a little bit easier next week so I can get some more stuff done around the house. And then probably the week after I'll go back to like three streams, and I'll probably do like an on and off every other week kind of thing. That way I won't burn myself out, but I can still get some streams in. Yeah. But yeah, I just love that brain where, brain who. She goes to a different school. All right, we're almost through. Almost through here. I can't use a lightning item on all of them, but I do have Ice Storm, so let's give this a try. Oh, nice. That's probably best case scenario right there. Then I think a normal jump will cover it. Perfect. No worries, and don't forget, you never have to stream. It's just if you like it, okay? No pressure or anything. Sleep is important, we all know that. I'm gonna say it's like 100% understand. You're not streaming for a long time. Yeah, I just kinda like part of it's I feel bad if I don't stream, but also it's like I have a lot of fun with it. How do I get that? How do I get that? I have a lot of fun with it. So I kind of miss it when I don't, and then I end up like getting stuck in this loop of feeling bad and then not having as lot of fun. And then it like weighs on my brain, and then I struggle to sleep more, so It's like this endless loop. I didn't get him. Well, that's okay. Go back. There we go. Yeah. So basically what I'm trying to do right now is just have a better balance, I guess. I don't want to go too all in on streaming, but I also don't want to go too all in on just working on the house. I need a bit of a better balance, so that's kind of what I'm trying to find right now, I think. I think it's the best way to describe it. Don't feel bad, I can handle it. I got a lot of trauma. You not streaming for a week ain't that bad. Don't feel bad if you don't stream. Yeah, so what I mean, I'll experiment a little bit. So like I said, go like commit to 3 streams this week. Probably take it easy next week and do like an on and off kind of thing. But I also have like so many ideas that I want to get to. So many stream ideas that I'm really excited for that I want to just do. So that's also kind of why I want to get back into it, because it is a lot of fun and I do enjoy it. That's a spiky parabuzzy. It's a buzzy with a spike and wings. Max HP is 5, attack is 3, and defense is 4. Hey, the same stats as a normal buzzy. Fire and explosions don't work on buzzies, in case you've forgotten. Ugh, worse yet, this one flies in the air and has a spike. What a total pain. You'd be better off using an item or a special move to take him out. Alright, we can do that. FNAF, exactly. Ow. They fast. Ugh. Yeah, no, exactly. Like, I have, another crowd control stream kind of ready to go for a day that I have the energy for it. I have a sort of like a co-op playthrough that I'm doing with like another friend who's also a streamer, that I've just been pushing off because I've been like too tired to really have the energy for it. But I'll leave that as a surprise for when it eventually happens. And then I have a couple other things I want to do as well. Yeah, Five Nights at Freddy's, Sims. I have this cozy game that I want to play this fall. Because I like doing seasonal streams, especially the fall. I love the cozy, spooky vibes, so I want to try and do as much of that this season as possible. Yeah. No pressure, but also, I think it'll be fun. It'll be good. I'll get to it eventually, I think, is what I have to remind myself too. Bobbery. Yeah. And also, I also realized that this year I was gonna go to the Nether in Minecraft, and I put out like a whole trailer for it and everything, and I haven't gotten to it yet. 1 hour stream? Hell yeah. So yeah, I have that too. Nice. Oh, we're leveling up. There's been something in this eye this whole past week. Anyway. I'm gonna opt. I know flower power would be good, or fart power would be good, but I'm gonna opt for, I think, HP this time. Just cause the enemies have started dealing, like, more damage. And I've been getting, like, closer and closer to death each time now. It's been a while since we've upgraded HP as well, so I'm just gonna do that. But we can do FP next time. I think it'd be a good idea. Perfect. Let's just do this. You got a Quake Hammer badge. Damage all enemies on the ground or ceiling. Don't I already have that? That's not the button I wanted. Huh, interesting. Wear this, use head rattle. 2 FP are required to use this attack, which may temporarily confuse an enemy, hindering their actions. Wearing 2 or more of these badges causes the enemy to stay confused for longer, but the move will require more FP. What about this one? So wearing 2 or more of these increases the attack power, but the move will require more FP. Okay. It already costs 3 FP. Which I think goes down by 1. So, in the end it would cost 3 FP, but... it's only been... it's been useful in particular instances. I don't know if I'll worry about it. Where this use multi-bounce. Lets you attack multiple foes by successfully executing the action commands. Shrink stomp, soft stomp, power smash. Powerfully smash a foe for increased damage. Ooh, hammer throw. Throw a hammer toward one enemy at any distance and damage them regardless of their defense, wearing 2 or more of these. So I think this is good maybe for the flying enemies. Picture time. Yeah, I think that's probably good for flying enemies. Wear this to use Ice Smash. I'm guessing this will freeze. Let Mario use Charge for 1 FP. It's your partner charge. Reduces the damage Mario takes by half when he has 5 HP or less. Never succumb to a first strike. I think that means when they hit me, I'll grab that. Why not? Actually, wait, before I do that. Wear this to use Tornado Jump. 3 FP are required to use this attack, which can deal additional damage to all mid-air enemies through successful action commands. Wearing 2 or more of these badges increases. So it's like people who are flying, I guess. Boosts defense by 1 with a successful guard action command by a partner. The enemies will sometimes miss when trying to attack Mario. That kind of sounds hype, actually. Sometimes they miss. I think I'm gonna do that one. Okay, we can drop down here. Or we can roll down here. I kind of feel like they're both going to lead to the same. Oh. I think you got the name because you, Eden, and Midnight is your purple theme because you like purple a lot. Good guess. Actually, Midnight Eden came from my edgy teenage phase. On Tumblr. I was renaming myself because my old username was Dragon Girl because I used to really like this show called Dragon Booster. And I was renaming myself and I was like, what do I do? So I wanted to put my name as like Midnight Paradise. Like I was picturing like this pretty garden with a bunch of like dark purple roses in the middle of the night with like this starry backdrop. And I was like, yeah, this is totally edgy. This makes me look so hardcore, man, like dark purple roses. And so I was like, Midnight Paradise sounds kind of weird though. So then I like Googled like a thesaurus and I looked up other words for paradise and Eden was one of them. And that's pretty much the story of how I got my name, and it's just kind of stuck because I still like the visual of it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, it's not like a super deep meaning. I also used to go by Midnight Rose. I don't know why I switched to Eden instead of Rose, but I like it too. I think it's fun. Great backstory. Thank you. All right, let's go to the left and see what happens. Okay. Oh no! Oh, I see, okay. Edgy teen stuff, pretty much, yeah. I was deep, deep into my Evanescence phase and I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. I was like, man, I want like a really pretty, like elegant sounding name. Give me coins! Give me coins or give me death. Oh, nice. I don't hate it though. Yeah, like it's obviously not cringy enough that I felt the need to change it. I still like it. And a lot of people have started calling me like MIDI, like M-I-D-D-Y. So it's kind of just, I just stick with it. I kinda like it. It's fun. Hold L and release it when the star lights up. Okay. Neat. Okay, that's kind of useful. I kind of want to see. I kind of want to see what happens with that. Direct attacks will be countered. Okay, cool. Ow. So I have to not... How does that work? That is pretty great, actually. You know what I'm upset about? What? Pride flag ain't there, so homophobic. Oh, okay, so that explosion won't work on them. Gotcha. I see. Yeah, I can't remember who else. I think it was in another channel that pointed out, like, it's missing a lot of different flags. It's not that difficult. Yeah, they have trans, pan. I know they have bi. They have Ace in there, but there's a couple other ones that they're missing. I honestly don't know. I don't know why. Okay, so explosions don't work. Oh, and these guys. Who's calling me? Okay, it's not ringing. I'll just let it voicemail get it. My phone just lit up. I'm like, why am I being called right now? What was I gonna do? We'll defend. Ow. Huh, interesting. I don't really know what that did. If I was doing it wrong. The only trace of me, the gay gremlin, is in the LGBTQ flag with the green part. I hadn't really thought about... All the colors, like, meant something, didn't it? Okay, now I'm curious. Hold on. What do the colors in the LGBTQ flag mean? Okay, so this is the new, like, the progress. The Intersex Inclusive Progress Pride Flag is what this is. Red represents life, orange represents healing. Yellow represents sunlight. It functions as the flag's radiant and bright center. The color yellow is said to stimulate new ideas and thoughts. Okay. The color green in the original Pride flag is meant to convey nature. Nature is a healing place, and the color green is associated with prosperity and growth. The indigo or blue in the original Pride flag was for serenity, and violet represents spirit. And then in the new Pride flag, black and brown represents people of color, pink, baby blue, and white represents trans people. Yeah. I thought gay was the green one. It's not expertise though. You got the earth flag or something. Yeah, I don't know. But I mean, I don't see a problem with green. Green representing gay people. I think that's pretty standard. I don't know. I've seen it. I think I've seen it like that before. Obviously not an expert either, though. Okay, so we have... Okay. Like, I'm just a gay gremlin. I deserve a flag emoji. True, honestly, fair and true. One. What am I supposed to get from this. But it worked, I think. I have no idea what I did. Okay. I honestly have no idea. Not make sense in my mind, but all right. I have no idea. You got Ultra Boots! Fuck yeah.
Hi, it's me again, Donut. It's nice to see you again. Oh, way to get the Ultra Boots! Now your jump attack power will go way, way, way up! And you can use a new jump technique, too! Let's practice it right now! It's a little hard, but I know you'll get it! Just hold down A, rotate L to make your body fold up! Then release A to do a giant spring jump! Remember, though, you need to rotate a lot before you release A, okay? Okay! The spring jump can help you reach new areas, since you can grab pipes above you. Move, left or right to move along a pipe and press B to let go of a pipe.
Wow.
It's not making my mind is right as long as we get further. Exactly. I got my mom to play Mario Odyssey today. I want to do a Minecraft video or something with my mom so badly. The problem is, like, most video games make her dizzy. I know I'm evil. Did she at least have fun?
Wow, way to go, Mario. That was very well done. Are you clear on the controls? Okay, now you've mastered the spring jump. With the spring jump, you can attack blocks and other things in high places. For example, if you punch a panel from below, you can knock off something sitting on top of it. Oh yeah, you can use the spring jump in battle too. So, see you next time, I guess, and good luck on your quest!
She had fun for a little bit until she got to the Sand Kingdom. She rage quit. Like a true gamer. If you don't rage quit at least once in your life, have you really had a true gaming experience? There we go.
Whee!
One more. How do I get that? Oh, like this, apparently. She's a gamer, hell yeah! We gaming now. Alright. Whack. Gotta love my mom though. Nice. Hell yeah. Ooh. Jump is red now. I think. Has it always been red? Or I thought it was blue before, so. I don't know. Fair. Mary's the only one that needs it apparently. Okay, cool. Oh, I was not fast enough with the hammer. Oh. Held message for reason, sexuality, sex, or gender. Auto mod. It's just me, a little gay gremlin, nothing to worry about. That's fine. I'll allow it. yeah, that's what I want. I don't respect my sexuality. I think Automod is just a little overly cautious. Which honestly is fair. I appreciate it. Etchy. Automod is just homophobic. Exposed. Automod exposed. Nailed the timing on that one. Let's go. Yeah, no, I actually, Automod is pretty like trigger happy. But as someone without like really any moderators, or at least not. Yeah, I guess. I have moderators, just like I have friends who come in and help, but obviously they can't be here all that often. It has been helpful. Oh, let's go. The nice thing about Automod though is that it does allow me to just sort of approve the message, like override it. Dang, that didn't actually do anything for me because my stars were already full. I'm here almost every time. True. Yeah, actually, you've been showing up fairly regularly. That's pretty cool. Appreciate that. Nailed it.
I do about that? What about I do about that?
See, I don't really want to use an item on just one enemy. Great. I'm glad you've been enjoying it. It's been a lot of fun. Honestly, it's like starting to get, I feel like I really found the groove for these streams. Especially ever since adding the like sound alerts. Those have been a lot of fun. I ain't no idea on how being a mod works and stuff. I will respect sexuality. Totally fair. Honestly, I don't really know how being a mod works either. I think it's just keeping the channel rules going. That's about it. That's all I would expect from a moderator. I'll figure that out at some point in the future. I'm not super worried about it right now. Everyone who comes in has been pretty chill anyway. Auto mod and I think it's Stream Elements or Nightbot or whatever I have has gotten any of like the spam. Like anyone trying to sell viewers or something. So it's been pretty good. I want those coins. I want the coins. No, I missed both coins. Wait. I got it. Let's go. Let me check the channel rules because I ain't got no idea about what they are. Gotta be sure to follow the rules. Honestly, I think they're pretty like common sense rules and most people follow them. Okay, so we've been through here. I guess the other one drops you down here, actually. Yeah, so I'm not too worried about trying to figure out where that goes. I think we're good. Yeah, how do I get that? Quite common sense, yeah. Like, I don't think anything's too over the top. The only one that I've had to add was the rule about like not selling stuff. Because I would have some people come in and try to like sell viewers and whatever, or sell stuff like that. Very shitty people. Honestly, some of them are just like, some of them are artists just trying to make a living, I guess. Others are probably, like, most of it's probably spam, which is unfortunate, or a scam, sorry. But the ones trying to sell viewers, I just kind of go, like, why? I don't think there's really a point to that. Because, like, the funnest part about streaming is, like, interacting with people, and if you're just, like, if it's just bots that are boosting your numbers, it's not really that fun. Like, I ain't gonna be a traitor? We mean... I have to use a mushroom. Cool. I'm not gonna go to someone else's stream because they said it in chat. Oh, yeah. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, actually, I haven't had anyone come in and try to, like, promote their own stream. I've just had people try to sell me stuff, but I have seen, in, like, other streams where that's happened, and it's just kind of silly. Yeah, it's just silly. Okay, an ice thing. I probably want to... swap this out for that. Yeah. That sun's really cool looking. I think it's supposed to be a sun. It's kind of crazy looking. If it's not, I don't, you know what? I'm not gonna read too much into that. I love how it looks. Yeah! No, I love the art style of this game so much. That's just like a crazy looking object. Okay, yeah, I think I did everything in here. I'm just backtracking to see if there's anywhere I can like reach now that I couldn't before. Any shows, series you've been watching recently? Well, there's a new fairy tale series out, a new anime, The Thousand Year Quest, or was it Hundred Year Quest or Thousand Year? I can't remember. I think it's Hundred Year, Fairy Tale, Hundred Year Quest, yes. So I've been watching that, which has been fun, because I love fairy tale. Fairy tale's so much fun. I've been keeping up with My Hero Academia, and then, Bleach is making a return, the new season. I'm waiting for the English dub, but honestly I might just cave and watch the English sub, because I love Bleach so much. yeah, it's been a good time. Lots of anime that I watch has been updating regularly recently, so that's been fun. Elevator key! I didn't even know that's what we were looking for, to be honest. Anime. Yeah, pretty much. They've all been updating. Love anime. It's so good. Like, so I can understand people who don't like animated series not liking anime, but when someone tells me, like, they don't like anime, it's confusing because there is, like, there are so many different genres. Yeah, like there's gonna be guaranteed, unless you just don't like animated shows, there's guaranteed to be something that people would like. And for me, I always love like fantasy kind of stories. Pokecatch. I love the idea that you've just kind of been lurking and waiting and waiting and waiting for the right Pokemon to finally come into chat and be like, yes, here it is, my moment. I'm gonna catch this Pokemon. Also, hi. You used the elevator key.
Yay!
They're kind of cute though. They're kind of cute. Look at their little eyes. I like them.
Mario, darling, what on earth are these hopping creatures?
Hey, you caught it! Let's go! Let's go!
No matter, we must see them on their way and use the switch.
By the way, I'm absolutely only roasting Midnight Slayer because that's my mom. I'm not just like roasting some random chatter, just to be clear. Hello. Good information. Yeah, I thought I would just clear that up a little. She also gets very excited when she gets the first sound, you know? The first redemption. It's really sweet, actually. Before I start each stream, she'll like try to have it almost already opened and then just be like, I'm gonna get it! I'm gonna get first today! I'm gonna get it! It's really cute, actually. Was chasing Aurora, but there's a city in the way. Oh yeah, so we live near a city, and it just happens to be like north of us. So it blocks the northern lights, if there are any. Then I'll try to be first. That's so funny. That's actually so funny. Oh, I love that. Bridge control room. Yeah, see, that would have told me everything I needed to know. Instead, I just went through here because I was like, ooh, obvious door is obvious, and then didn't ever think about it again. Stealer spotlight, no hate towards her though. No, that's honestly, it's really funny. More precisely, I dislike others taking my first. I love that you've like laid claim to it. But no, that's so funny. That's so funny. Good luck, Ma. I'll have to just like reach out to Aiden on Instagram and be like, psst, I'm going live soon so you can get first. I'm up for the challenge. Hey. That, or I'll start stream when I'll have to distract my mom first. I'll be like, hey, can you like go and do this for me real quick and then start stream so that everyone else has a chance to get first. That's so funny. I love that. For sure, just give me a message. You got a close call when your partner is at Herblo. Foes will sometimes. Miss? Deal half damage? I don't know. Bring it. Oh, this is so funny. You guys are great. Yeah, I'm not gonna show any favoritism. If my mom wants to claim the first, she's gotta like earn it, you know what I mean? No favoritism from me, no like, psst, I'm going live soon. I'm just gotta earn it. It's gotta be fair for everyone, you know? I guess we can talk to you.
Hey, thanks a lot, Mario. Now we we'll get you guys rolling. The day is just passing you on by. Hurry all aboard, everybody. Have a good trip.
All right, so we have successfully returned all the items. King K, sup, Gonzales?
Yo, G-Money, it's me, King K, your bud from the Glitz Pit. I know you remember me. How you doing? What, you off KOing fools left and right somewhere else? I'm still living large in the minor league, but I'm keeping busy. You know how it is. I gotta thank you again for convincing me to stay. You fired me up good.
So are we ever gonna chill again or what? Or are we just gonna meet in the ring? Careful, next time you front on the King K, I'm gonna be way, 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 way better. Keep it real, King K.
So we can actually go back to the Glitz Pit, I think, and rank up from like the minor leagues all the way up to champion again. That's something we can do. And there's something else that we could do.
Oh, the Pit of 100 trials, Pit of 1,000 trials, whatever it is. That's something else we can do as well after we finish our playthrough, if you guys are interested. Gotta earn it from now on. I'll have an alarm on my notifications. Very often I miss out. That's true. I think you've, it's been pretty balanced, I think. That's funny. I like it. May the odds be ever in your favor.
All aboard! Ready to hop on board? Yes. Let's go!
Oh, they're just staying here. Okay. You bet I'll be using this emoji when I get it. Hell yeah.
Bing bong, bing bong.
Attention all passengers, thank you for your patience. Our next stop is our last, Poshley Heights.
Sweet. Is there anywhere I want to go? Anywhere I want to explore?
Welcome, welcome. Today's dinner is the mushroom full course. Hey, but in my opinion, even though this chef is good and all, he only seems to be able to cook with mushrooms.
That's a little scary.
Hello. The mushrooms in tonight's dinner were just picked at Riverside Station.
Oh my. Do you honestly think those are edible? I guess we'll chat with everybody. And then we'll sleep. Well, I will finally get home tomorrow. It's been a rather long time, to be honest. But the hour has grown late. You should get some rest, Luigi. It has been a long day. Or this one to show respect because she tried but lost. Honestly, it depends on the mood that you're in. I think you could get away with either.
Good evening to you. Tomorrow's the day that our big deal goes down. I've checked the contracts and all that's left is to get a nice big breakfast tomorrow. On the expense account, of course.
Hell yeah.
Hello, Mr. Gonzales. I've heard about your present for little bub. You gave him the engineer's autograph, didn't you? I wish we thought of that. Old Bob and I would so like to please him on his big day.
Who knew my little bub liked trains so much?
Perhaps I'll get him a solid gold train set when we get to Botchley Heights.
Hey, mister. My mom and my dad, they said they're going to get me a train set when we get to Poshley Heights. I can't wait, I can't wait, I can't wait, I can't wait, I can't wait.
Aww. I'll use this one. I mean, I am the little gay gremlin, so most likely this one. We'll see about it though. Why is it so homophobic? I don't know. Every time, it's not just dinging the word gay, it's dinging like whatever word comes before it. So in this case, it's dinging like lil gay, and I don't know. I mean, actually, I can understand why it might be like cautious, but this is probably just on like the borderline of being overly cautious. Because at least in like in this setting or in this context, I know it's like in good faith. But yeah, I guess if it was like a complete stranger, Automod would be a bit more justified. Is it saying kids can't be gay or what? I think it's more so like they're concerned about gay being used as like an insult. Honestly, I don't know if kids do that as much these days, but it was definitely a thing like when I was going into high school, like people were just starting to grow out of it. So that might just be why it's why Automod is dinging it. Otherwise, I'm honestly not totally sure.
Hello, Detective Mario. I guess we owe you again for getting us out of Riverside.
It's like you little that. Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, like that. Yeah, see, yeah. Okay, yeah, held a message. In this case, it's held a message for bullying. I click deny. I'm a little scared what it's gonna do, because you can either allow or deny it. Okay, yeah. So what it does is when I allow something, it adds a permitted term. And then when I block something, it adds it, or deny it, it adds it as a blocked term. So it's kind of neat. Like, you can customize it, help train it a bit. It wasn't meant to be mean. No, it's all good. I understand. You're good. It's just as like an example, right? You're good.
This is your last night on the train, but please have a good one, alright?
Oh man, I so badly want to take like a cross-country train ride and just be able to sleep on a train. Like, I sleep so well in like a moving car. I can only imagine getting like a full night's sleep in a train would be so nice. I don't know if that's a thing anymore. It just sounds so, so cozy though. Oh yes, this is our room. Hang on. Oh. So, tomorrow we shall see Poshley Heights at long last, will we? We simply must get the crystal star before those others. We must. Well, let's get a wink of beauty sleep before then, hmm? Okay, good. It's not going to force me to sleep yet. You can't sleep in your own bed, but somehow you can sleep on a train. I never said there was any logic. There's a little guy.
We'll be in Poshley Heights tomorrow. I feel sad I won't see you after that. But please do come visit. I won't be going anywhere. But it's late now. Good night.
Aw. Logic, we don't know her. True. Facts. I think it's just like the motion and kind of the noise. Like there's the white noise it makes. It's very comforting.
When we hit Parsley Heights, I won't be able to eat this amazing Excess Express chow. How depressing.
We're finally going to arrive in Parsley Heights tomorrow. About time, I should say. But that is for tomorrow. Now it is beauty sleep time. Late nights cause wrinkles.
And then I don't think there's anybody else in here. Yeah. Okay. What about the conductor?
We'll pull into Parsley Heights tomorrow. How was your Excess Express experience? I guess I don't even have to ask. You know why, sir? Because the Excess Express is fabulous.
It's good to know she's your mom now. I found it interesting how fast she's always here. Yeah. I've always been like, I don't know if I should say that she's my mom or not. But I think, I've asked her and she's fine with it. And then, my brother occasionally pops in, too. There we go. Would you like to go to bed for the night? Yes. Excess Express, day 3. The family, yeah.
Morning of a new day. I love it. It's so cool and brisk, too. I love that.
Honestly, it just looks so soothing. It looks like this would be so good to sleep in.
Oi, Mario, how's your stash? Life on the island feels great. When the sun rises, I wakey wakey, and when it sets, I tuck in for snoozer time. Perfect for a simple bloke like me, right? Every now and then, that louse Flavio stops by and spits out some bit of drivel about treading water instead of seizing life. But I just tune him out. So, you off on another adventure? I think that suits you best. Give them ooligans what for and save your princess from Papatch. I have advance warning before notifications go out. Maybe. Unless I distract you. I can do it. I could be like, oh, good. Oh no, does the dog need to go outside?
There's a large sanctum in Parsley Heights. The picture on display there is so big, it looks like you could just jump inside.
I will get first, just saying. I didn't mean to start a feud, but it's actually kind of funny.
good morning, sir. It's quite quiet this morning, wouldn't you say? Is there something on the windshield? Yeah, what are those things?
Are those things from the station yesterday? They must have stowed away.
Oh, what?
should I do? First, we have to ensure the passenger's safety. But I have to keep driving the train. Mario, can you check out the rest of the train for me? It's just that music distracting. You might get first. We'll see anything can happen. I think we've already figured out there is nothing in any of these cars. Oh! Ah! There were a lot of black things everywhere. Did you save me? Wow. Oh, goes it, traveler? Welcome to the sales stall. Gotta make that money, you know what I mean? You gotta get that grind. Come back anytime. Switches right back into customer service mode. Anybody here? Nope. Anybody in here? Nope. Anybody in here? Nope. Oh, so I guess I was wrong about Miss Mouse. Sparks, 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 sparks. No, they've gotten inside the train cars. We have to clear them out. Whack. Be gone. Oh, they have the poor conductor. How horrible. Please save him. Your cosplay. Toad is traumatized, but the money. True. God. This poor guy. Detective Mario, you saved us again. Hey, I must have been taken by those black things when I was sleeping. Scary. Where in the world did they come in from? Oh, wait, they still have our other paying passengers. Oh, those poor souls. Oh, I missed. Two-hour stream, by the way. Hell yeah. Oh, okay. I was too far back this time. There we go. That was funny. Whoa. Damn, look at them all. I'll be honest, I don't really think I'm doing much. Oh.
Smorg! Alrighty! Here we go! She ain't saving nothing, I know.
What is that nasty thing? Oh, Mario, look! It's got the other passengers!
Oh, help!
Well, damn!
This is like some Stranger Things shit. You know what I mean? Smorg! Or is it more like, Smorg?
Oh damn, can't flee this fight, alright.
Well, you know what we have to do first.
S'mores gotta love him.
That's a smorg. Lots of s'mores gathered to create this huge monster. Max HP is 50, attack is 5, and defense is 1. It attacks with weird tentacles. We won't do any damage to the main body unless we defeat the tentacles first. That's simple biology. The tentacles will regenerate, but use that time to deal a ton of damage, okay? It may also take other forms that expose more of its gross body, but boost its attack power. Let's just hurry and beat this thing down so we can save those trapped passengers.
Go, God!
Okay, the timing on that's really weird.
That's a lot of damage. I am really glad we grabbed the HP when we did.
Okay, let's try it.
Oh, let's go. That was pretty sick.
Okay, 6 damage. It could be better, but it wasn't terrible.
Normal hammer do against this?
5? Okay. Gotta love how she knows absolutely everything about every enemy in the game. Yeah, she's a big nerd. She's big brain.
Okay, that wasn't terrible.
The timing on these things is so weird.
Alright. Look how high he go.
Okay, not bad. Not bad at all. We're getting there. You be a bird. Yeah. You're sending him off into space. Oh, my timing with that was way off. Oh, great. That was not good. The shocked face is so real right now. Okay, I'm gonna try. Ooh, I'm gonna try it. Oh, that did like nothing against that one. Damn. This is bad. Oh. That's why we have the mushrooms. That's why we got the shrooms. That's what the shrooms are for. Oh, what are we doing? What are we doing? Oh! All the punies ran away! Oh! Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go head bonk here. Regular head bonk. And then we're gonna go shroom powers! Hell yeah! Earth Tremor. Let's go. Oh, let's go. All right. Not bad. Not bad at all. Nice. All right, what's he gonna do? We know there's a phase two. There's gotta be, right? Oh. Are you kidding me? That's so many star points. Holy shit. Maybe not, but yeah, maybe there's not a phase two. That's insane. Damn. I'll take it. I'll take it. Honestly, I'm not really sure. I needed more flour. Well, you know what? I'm sure it'll come in handy, actually. Smog, smog, smog. Or butt power, yeah. I'm sure it'll come in handy. I think my next one's gonna be HP and then BP. Thank you. Boy. It's like all you did for 3 days was save us. How can we ever thank you? Everyone's safe now. It's all thanks to you. Oh, thank you much. You saved my life. No, stupid tongue of mine. You saved my life. So, did you all know this dashing fellow has been the famous Luigi all along? We will soon arrive at Poshley Heights. Ladies and gentlemen, please prepare to disembark.
Love how no one reacted to him. No one, like, paid him any mind. They're all like, Luigi? Sure, dude. It's basically what we did for 3 days. That was very true. Yeah. Real, though.
Attention all passengers, now arriving at Poshley Heights.
Oh, I swear, don't call me Luigi.
Please watch your step and be sure to take all your belongings with you. And thank you for choosing the Excess Express.
We're finally here, Mario. Let's hurry up and find the Poshley Sanctum that the professor was talking about. That went really well, actually. So many stars. Holy heck.
Ghosty! Goodbye. There's a large sanctum in Poshley Heights. The picture on display there is so big, it looks like you could just jump inside.
We've heard that already. But, you know, thank you. Any last words?
I already got a return ticket. That's right. 3 more days on the gravy train.
Good for you. Good for you. Yeah, he seems happy.
That's nice.
I know it was a wild ride, sir, but did you enjoy the Excess Express experience? Please come again. I assure you will be more sedate. Because the Excess Express is fabulous. Do 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 do.
We have a bit of time until our next departure.
Oh, I like the roses. The roses are pretty. And I like this stained glass thing. It's very lovely.
Bob Ross.
How did I do your voice? Now that we're here, we'll purchase that birthday present for little Bob.
Hey, mister! I'm gonna get a train set, the coolest one ever invented. I could just have them buy me a real train, but maybe I'll save that for next year.
Oh my god.
You wouldn't happen to have a train set for sale, would you? A gold one, perhaps?
I just, like, invade your house.
They have a pool.
Oh. There's a shh. There's a shark. Why is there a shark in their pool?
That's some rich people shit, my dude.
Thank God they ain't buying him a house or a car. True.
Business people I'm waiting for haven't arrived yet, so I may do some sightseeing at Poshley Sanctum. On the expense account, of course, as if you have to ask by now.
What do we say about going in random people's pools? You'll get bit by a shark, I'm telling ya.
Welcome to my vacation home, you marvelous man. The train journey certainly was thrilling, hmm?
This is a nice home. Nice little home. Where's your bed? Oops.
Hmm.
There's something hidden back here. Yeah! That looked way too suspicious of an area for there not to be anything. She ain't got no bed. She's sleeping on the floor. Maybe she sleeps on that couch. Oh my god, these guys are cute.
So lovely house, eh? Yeah, sure. Take your time to soak in all of its majesty. I built it with even the smallest details in mind, making every nook special. Not only the interior, but the facade as well. Yeah, look around outside too. I guess it's sort of fun to live here. But I can't eat snow cones or make little snowmen or go ice skating. Or any of the stuff I did in Shiver City, eh? Don't know what you got till it's gone.
Who's the perfect guy? The perfect guy! They're so cute! They're so cute. Oh, they got a mini train model set in here. They like trains. Oh, what's back here? Nothing, I guess. Okay. Simple but cute. They're adorable.
I heard Poshley Heights was a quiet place, but there are lots of tourists, eh? Maybe I should just open up a store selling Shiver City souvenirs. Yeah, maybe so.
I got an in coupon! Let's go!
Welcome to you! How do you like to buy some high-quality fresh pasta as a souvenir? One package costs 50 coins for 10 HP and 5 FP! Rich people shit. Oh! Jeez, yeah. That's crazy. Cray, 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 cray.
Come again, okay?
We are the Wandering Girls, the Traveling Sisters 3. We're staying in that luxury hotel.
Poshley Heights sure is a place for the richest of the rich, huh? We're thinking of going to see the Poshley Sanctum next.
Are there sharks in here? Yup. I like pasta but cheese. Yeah, that's a bit much.
Welcome, sir. This is the Royal Poshley Dark Park Tower. I thought it said Dark Tower, and I was like, we doing like rituals in here or something?
We promise a comfortable stay in the lap of luxury, the pinnacle of poshness. A room for the night costs a mere 30 coins. Would you care to stay?
I'm good for now, I think.
Then we look forward to your next visit, sir.
Bonjour, monsieur de la moustache. Isn't the lass at the reception desk magnificent? I shall stay here every night until her heart is mine. I shall not tire.
Sir, that looks like a child. Maybe we don't. Like, can we call cops on this guy? Like, that's a little weird, bro. Just saying. Pasta is more expensive than a day at a luxury hotel. Be for real. True, you right, that's weird. I'm genuinely wondering though if like if sometimes there's a different character here and that dialogue's not supposed to play when this character's here. I'm not really sure. Or if they changed it or something, it just seems a little weird. But anyway. Pokecatch, good luck! Also, that guy was kind of creeping on a lady last time we saw him. He just seems like a creepy dude in general. I don't like him.
It may not look like it, but I get pretty stressed out. Like, really bad, eh? But walking barefoot on the grass like this makes me feel much better. You betcha. Care to join me, guy?
Honestly, that sounds pretty great.
People ask me if I get tired of walking the same route every day. And I say, no way, Jose, because it's a bit different every day, you know? It's not the same as I was yesterday. I'm not the same as I was yesterday, neither are you, even the town changes. And you'll never see another day like today, so treat each day like it is unique.
That's pretty cute, actually. That's pretty nice.
Hey there. Ashley Heights is sure nice and warm, eh? Yeah, I really dig it here. Cold places make me sneeze.
Why do I feel like all these guys are just from Canada? Oh, I'd love to join such a cute little duck to walk in the grass. He's so adorable. So true.
Well, Ashley Sanctum is a rather famous building, eh?
They're all so Canadian.
And the painting inside isn't the only gorgeous thing. So is the building. I could just stare at it all day, you betcha.
There we go. Okay. Just, you know, I just had to check. We need to find a key. Danger, no entry. Okay. Oh. Oh, maybe there's a different way in. Hang on. Let me go check. Maybe you need to stay at the hotel to find the key, like I ain't no expert. Yeah. There's either something I need to do to trigger it, or like, can I just break a window? Be kind of funny. Or maybe there's another way in. Oh, hang on, there's a note. Gone traveling, Sanctum manager.
No way, that stinks, what now?
Ah, it is my dear Luigi. What are you doing at my doorstep, young fellow?
Or bribe them with pasta. That would work.
Oh, you live here? So you're the Sanctum manager. Dude, I thought you were a detective.
Well, yes. That is more like a hobby of mine, if the truth must be told. But enough chatter, Shall we go inside?
Alright. Well, that worked. Oh!
You're one step too late! We have the Crystal Star! Only without me.
What, What did I say about breaking a window?
Oh, crud. We're too late. We gotta go after them.
Just a second there, Luigi. Exactly what is going on here? Speak quickly. Yes, quite rudimentary. So, you were looking for the crystal star in this sanctum. Oh, yes. Very interesting. He's literally like, I'm a master at detective work. Then he confesses it's a little hobby. Yeah. Well, no cause for worry. The crystal star is safe. Yes, quite safe indeed. The stone that our rude friend stole was fortunately a red herring. A fake! Oh, this eye's bugging me again. It's fine. I'm fine. I think we're good. The real one is hidden somewhere in this sanctum to prevent such a theft. However, as to the location of the real crystal star. Well, as sanctum manager, I am, of course, prohibited from telling anyone. However, I do know where it is. Of that you can be most certain. Yes, indeed. Besides, I am sure a junior detective like yourself could find it on your own. Now, Luigi, put to use all of the razor-sharp sleuthing skills I have taught you. Make me proud.
Alrighty then. I deduce that someone broke this window!
I do like the colors used here. It's very pretty. Hang on, what's this way?
There's something I want. I want it. Pow. Yeah. Oh no.
Two and a half hour stream. Heck yeah. I think we're almost done with this chapter. I mean, I just kind of have the money. I don't really need an in coupon. Okay, that's it for here. She rich, she doesn't need a free coupon, duh. Yeah, I think, but I kinda like this mystery. The mysteries are fun, though. I think I'll drop this one. Was there anything else back here? No, okay. It's like telling Taylor Swift she got a free Gucci shirt, like, she can afford it, like, duh. Yeah, true. I mean, free stuff is nice, but I am genuinely of the opinion that if you can afford to pay for something, it's nice to, support other people.
Whoa, let's go.
Now, this is just a game, obviously, so it's not that big of a deal in a game, but, you know. And again, it's an if you can. It's not a mandatory thing. Obviously, if you can't, no one should feel guilty about that. Yeah. That's like obviously you have to take care of yourself first, and you should never put yourself out financially in order to try and support someone else. Of course, yeah, exactly. Like take care of yourself first. That's probably the best thing you can do. Because there's also lots of free ways that you can support other people. Literally, like, just chatting in the chat. There's so many free ways that you can support someone. It does not have to be monetary. But yeah, I kind of like the idea if I ever... I don't want to say, like, make it big, but if I'm ever at a point where I am financially, like, stable enough to... I want to support artists, support whoever I can, that kind of thing. It'd be nice. You know, give back. I'm here with the good gay gremlin vibes. Exactly, exactly. Just having good vibes is a huge, huge help. Because, you know, it makes the stream fun. It makes everything, like, everybody have a good time. That's it. That's all I ask. we Goombella. But yeah, mostly as a rule for myself, I'm like, if I can, I will. That's dark though. Purple just looks so wrong. These boos are so creepy. You take that back though, Purple. Max HP is 8, attack is 5, and defense is 0. Its HP and attack are high, but they're just like ordinary boos otherwise. So, just attack it like a normal boo. Get it before it turns invisible. Ooh. Like, it might not help you much financially, but fun is more important than $5, my opinion, though. No, that's totally fair. I mean, obviously there's free ways to support, like even just watching ads. Although I'm still gonna try and like run as few ads as possible because I know they're kind of annoying. But just being here and chatting is honestly like, whenever you can, it makes it fun, makes everyone have a good time. That's it. I just want to have a good time. You don't have ads? When you're subbed, you don't see ads, so you're good. Yeah, that's the other cool thing, is like, people gifting subs gives everyone like an ad-free experience, and then your viewing experience is better, and then we all get to just chill and have fun, and none of us have to worry about ads. So it's all good. I think if I shut them off, what ends up happening is it always runs pre-roll ads, which means anytime you refresh the screen or close and reopen the stream, it'll always run an ad, and I think that's so annoying. I wish there was a better way to deal with it on Twitch, but anyway. Yeah. Oh, I messed up. That's fine. But yeah, no, I kind of just, I just like hanging out, chilling. It's the best part about this, honestly. Sharing a game I like with some chill people. That's the best part. Whoa, what are these? Is that a money money badge? Makes more coins appear after a battle. That's cool. Yeah, that's one more thing I appreciate for getting free membership from you. No ads is quite nice, and the emojis. Yeah, no ads is kind of like the best part. like obviously I tried to make the emojis really cute and fun, and versatile, but it's really the no ads that's like the best part about it. It's subtle but very nice, basically. Yeah. No, because, like, with what YouTube's been doing lately, this is gonna take me on, like, something of a slight tangent, but with, with the way YouTube has been raging like a war against Adblock lately, it's just been super frustrating. Especially with, like, most creators are fine with people using an ad block. Mary can act an additional time this turn. Neat. I was kind of hoping. Okay, it didn't really work the way I wanted it to. That's fine. but yeah, as if YouTube doesn't make enough money already, you know? I honestly, if they aren't making enough money, I would love for them to be transparent about it. Otherwise, it just kind of seems greedy, or just, it comes across as, like, not really listening to their creators. It's just weird. The whole thing's weird. But YouTube, like, from what I understand from a lot of videos and stuff I've seen from other creators, YouTube's never really had a great history of, like, listening to their creators. Yeah. I could not imagine YouTube running out of money though, like, how else would you watch videos? Yeah, exactly, like, I'm all for doing what, I'm all for YouTube doing what they need to be able to, like, stay as a platform for people to, like, be creative and express themselves on, but also it's kinda, it's just very iffy, I don't know. Like, they're not very great at communicating with their content creators, you know? I feel like that's kind of where it's at. You got a crystal star, and your star power is now 7, and Mario learned the special move, Showstopper. Greedy, yeah. I'm sure it's like, yeah. Yeah. I was trying to think of a better word, but that's, I think for lack of better words, greedy sums it up. Mary found the 6th crystal star hidden craftily in the Poshley Heights Sanctum. Now, only 1 crystal star remains, but our hero does not know where Princess Peach is being held. Where could the last crystal star be, and where is Peach being held? Hoping this crystal star might yield answers, Mario and his friends return to Pennington. Hehe, getting it on. Oh, look at all the little dots. Okay, what does Showstopper do? Has a chance of defeating your enemies with a single blow. Like, Netflix is, you can watch movie series, but, like, where else other than YouTube? Would you watch people play games or talk or whatever? Yeah. I know there's some other video hosting websites, but they're not as well known or as developed as YouTube. But I could very much see in the next 10 years or so. I don't really see people leaving YouTube, but I see other video hosting, like, websites, like, alternatives starting to come out. Press the buttons in order as they appear on screen. Oh, crap. Did I not push? I did push the right one. Game? You robbed me. You robbed me. I was like, oh, did I push the wrong button? No, I did. I didn't. Rude. I even looked check. I don't know if I just didn't push it fast enough, maybe? I want to try that again. I'm just wondering if I didn't push it fast enough. That was the issue. Oh, I hit the wrong one there for sure. Nope, nothing. Okay. Never mind. We're just not going to use that one. I'm not good with. Oh, Palia updated, because you know. Or Palia. I'm just apparently not good with that one. I mean, I could try it again until I get it, but. Okay, I can attempt it one more time and see what happens. But pushing the correct button is my worst enemy in this because the Xbox buttons are reversed. What? I pushed Y! I actually pushed Y that time. I went Y, B, Y. So did I just push it too quickly? That's so confusing. I don't get it. I wonder if, like, I don't know. I wonder if you push it too fast. It doesn't register properly. That's just weird. That's just, I don't get it. 9 sitting through an hour button mashing like that. Honestly, fair. Well, I tried it until I don't have enough coins to use it anymore. That just seems a little too... Oh, that's not who I wanted to target. Oops. This is going great. No, I tried it until I ran out of points. That's fine. It doesn't seem reliable enough to use. Like, it's just kind of weird. All right. Now, I don't have to fight all of them. But I also don't mind battling them right now because they're giving me a lot of points. So that's kind of why I'm engaging instead of just running past them all. There we go. Gotta get her points. Yeah, exactly. I may as well try and level up as much as I can. Oh god, no. Although, if I'm gonna die, maybe I won't stick around. Oh, it's just one. Ooh. Nice. Okay, we got a badge. What I want to do real quick though. That's cool. It works. Well, he kind of looked like he dabbing. That's a good question. I feel like I need a dabbing emote now. Okay, we're gonna take out this ghost because I don't want him to use that spin dial. It's just gonna make everybody watching it feel sick. I need a fall emote. Oh. I do have... Well, I tried to make a ghost emote with like a witch hat before. It didn't totally work out. But a fall ghosty with some pumpkins. Oh, maybe he's like inside a pumpkin. I could do something like that. That'd be cute. Something like that. I finally remembered to plug in my tablet and charge it this week, so I could definitely do that. Okay, there's two more. Sorry, this part's actually like quite grindy and repetitive, but I figured it's probably our best opportunity to level up a bit, because I know we're reaching, like we're approaching endgame, and I just wanted to make sure we have what we need to successfully complete endgame. I remember it being really difficult when I was a kid, so maybe I'll try something. Yeah, if you feel like it, go for it.
got it though, yeah.
Yeah, I think I'll draw the ghostie with its head in a pumpkin. That'd be cute. Ugh. I'm gonna speed through this a little. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get the colors right, but I'll have fun and send it to you. That sounds good. Yeah, I've got all the colors and stuff that I use already saved in my app. So it's like it's no problem for me just to like whip up something quick. But if it inspires you, go for it. You know, have fun. Audience that time. We are up to 61 star points. And we are ready to go wrap this up now. Also, because I'm starting to get sleepy. like more than usual. So that is where it was. Nothing. Just talking to my brain. All geniuses do it. Congratulations, Luigi. You have found the real crystal star. So please, feel free to take it. I will just put another fake one over here. Well, traveling with you has been rather hectic, but I do admit, rather fun as well. I'm sure you still have a long road ahead, Luigi, but do not give up. That took half an hour. Sleep was important. Yeah, it kind of did. Or at least 20 minutes. I haven't been drinking my water. I'm bad. What is the matter with you idiots? Falling for a fake crystal star? That's asinine. Don't call me Luigi!
Sorry, dude. I mean, sir.
So, let me guess. This means Mario managed to get the real crystal star.
I'm gonna say maybe.
This mustache menace has nearly every crystal star now. They were mine! I think I'd better alter my plan a bit.
Before you do, Sir Grotus, I think I'd better tell you something.
What is it, fool?
Mumble, mumble.
What? Are you sure? Speak!
No joke, dude. I mean affirmative, sir dude. That is, I'm positive, sir.
Treason!
He angry. Strange, isn't it about time for Tech to call me in? Maybe he's busy. Oh, here we go.
Can we shower first? We can shower first. I love her hair with an updo, it's really cute.
Nobody will mind if I take a quick rinse.
We won't be going naked this time, right? Yeah, I hope not. Princess Peach with an updo. We're honestly so robbed that when we leave this room, it's like, it doesn't stay that way. Well, I guess this counts. I mean, at least it's like off screen and she puts her dress back on.
How refreshing. I feel like a new princess.
I love her hair in an updo so much, and honestly, we just get robbed. We get so robbed that we don't get to keep her hair like this. Like, it's so cute. Alright. Goodbye, updo. She's also smiling, and then she loses her smile. I feel so bad for her. I don't see no moves when she got naked the first time and this time either, so like, kind of the same. I guess so, yeah. I guess that's a fair point.
Hello, Tech. What do you want today?
Princess Peach, I have reached a conclusion.
A conclusion?
I have struggled with whether to obey orders or to speak to you. And I have also struggled with what I should believe.
Tech, you don't sound right. What's going on with you?
Princess Peach, please escape from this place as quickly as possible.
Escape? Tech, what do you mean by that? I mean, why all of a sudden?
The data you procured has been analyzed, and something terrible is... No, I will not say, but I have found out everything about Sir Grotus' plans.
Grotus' plans? You mean about conquering the world?
Yes, and among those plans was the reason you are being held here. According to the data.
Okay, so sexuality is a no-no, but boobs and nude not be for real. Actually, you're so right. I'm kind of surprised that the auto mod did not pick up on that. What?
No way. That's impossible. I don't believe it.
Yes, everything is true. That is why you must escape from here as fast as possible.
How can I do that, Tech? I mean, I don't even have the slightest idea where I am.
I will not hide anything anymore. No, not from you. I will tell you everything. The place where you are currently imprisoned. This is the moon.
The moon? You mean the moon that hangs up in the sky at night? That moon?
Guys, hang on. Wait, I was gonna say, what other moon is there? But can we talk about Mini Moon for a second? Can we talk about how the fact that for like, I think a month or two, we have two moons right now. Mini Moon, my beloved, I'm going to have a complete arc with this, okay? And it's going to be called my Mini Moon arc because I am gonna cry when Mini Moon leaves our orbit. Like, it's so sad. It's just Mini Moon is just dropping in to say hi, and then is gonna leave forever. Can't do this to me. I've grown attached. I'm devastated that we're only gonna see Mini Moon for a little bit. Just a little while, and then he's gonna leave. I'm so upset about it.
That is correct. He's like, hi, and then he just... it literally is just, hi, and then it's just, bye.
And then you never see him again. It's just so sad. I'm totally normal about this. No, literally, like, yeah, that's me cry. me cry, me little ghost cry.
But that's...
Boop. Yeah. Yeah. It's me. Me, my life reaction.
But that's unbelievable. How in the world am I supposed to escape?
There is a way. You can't escape, but you must follow my instructions exactly.
By the way, I'm trying to make text sound a little more, like, naturally spoken here. Because I feel like tech has been developing humanity this whole time. Distracted, the lights are dancing. Are you telling me there's an aurora right now? I'll have to go out and see it after stream.
But Tech, won't they know that you helped me? Won't you get in trouble?
That is inconsequential. I would like you to be safe. That is all that matters.
Tech.
I am the base's computer. No one will know if your escape... No one will know of your escape if I keep silent.
Yes, or take a fast break.
Nah, I'm sure they'll still be there in 10 minutes. Right? Right?
We'll finish up with Peach's part, and then we might get a Bowser scene. And then hopefully we'll save. And maybe, I don't think we'll be able to see it, but maybe, like, on camera. I'm a little tempted to take my phone out and live stream and be like,
the lights.
Please do not worry about me. Escape as quickly as possible.
Okay, Tech.
I don't know, don't ask me, I ain't Canadian. I never seen no lights like that. Usually we don't either. Usually you have to be like very much up in the north. But like the northern part of the country. But this year has been, it's been very active this year. Because there's a solar storm, so normally we wouldn't get to see them, but we've actually been able to see them a couple times.
But I must inform Mary about all this before I go. This is no longer just my problem.
Understood.
Oh no. Hold it right there, Princess Peach.
Eek! You!
Tech, you miserable machine. We all know what you're up to, traitor.
Sir Grotus, I...
In my most paranoid moments, I never thought my own computer would betray me. Well, it doesn't really matter in the end, I suppose. Especially since it ends here.
You monster! What are you planning to do with him?
Only one thing to do with a malfunctioning computer. Cut the circuit and delete all the programs and data that caused the malfunction. Obviously, all data relating to Princess Peach must go as well. Yes, we must be absolutely sure nothing like this ever happens again.
No, I am...
Nice.
3-hour stream, hell yeah. I saw the picture on your Insta and some Google pictures. That's all I've ever seen of him. For most of my life, that was all I ever saw too. Yeah, I think this year, or this last year, was like the first time I'd ever fully seen them.
I am normal. There is no malfunction.
Pipe down, Tech. X-Knots. At the same time, press the red buttons on Tech's sides.
Got it, sir.
Tech, no!
Mail sent. Princess Peach, I love you.
Ah! deletion complete. Your dog, by the way, such a cute picture. Thank you. You still have very, he has like such a puppy face, even though he's like, I think 7 now. This is fine. I'm fine, guys. It's okay. First mini moon and now tech. That's fine.
Tech!
Yeah. Too bad, Princess Peach. Tech is no longer with us.
No, you inhuman beast! How could you?
Princess Peach, just stop it. This is no time to be worrying about a computer. We have a very important role for you to play now. Yes, very important.
No!
Gah! Yeah, we're getting a lot of use out of the sad ghost today.
Bowser, save me!
I've got no crystal stars. I can't find Princess Peach. Twilight Town was, well, it wasn't exactly glorious. What's going on here? If this keeps up, Mario's gonna steal everything from my grasp, as usual.
The lights better be breakdancing once you're there.
Your massiveness. We did it! The Magic Koopa Scouts found a suspicious underground chamber. It isn't even down on my maps. Yeah, really suspicious. Something must be there.
About time. Well done. This is where it all turns around for me. Definitely.
The Hammer Bros Battalion is attempting to breach the chamber at the moment. The area is impenetrable. They're scraping tooth and nail in there.
No problem. Direct me there. I'll blast us through. I'm Bowser, baby!
Ouija? Oh. Oh, he's just kind of like, he's just there. Bro is just chilling.
Let's go!
I like playing as Bowser. It's actually pretty cool. I guess I have to hop that. Oh, okay. This is fine. He didn't jump nearly as far as I thought he would. Oh my god, I'm tiny! Yeah, the jumping is very precise. Give me the coins! Oh, I can't reach them. No! He does not jump that far. I keep wanting him to jump farther than he does. Oh, why did I do that? When I knew it was gonna happen. Oh, he can ground pound. Oh, okay, interesting. You got this, thank you. I will fully admit that I am not great at 2D platformers. I prefer 3D. Oh. Where did we go? Can I go down the pipe? No? Okay. Alright, weird. I feel very anticlimactic. Oh, dog barking.
It's
Incredible, Lord Bowser. Nothing stood in your way. You couldn't be more super.
Please, no problem. I felt right at home, but where are we now?
She didn't get the top of the pole? No, I didn't.
Gracious me. Look, Lord Bowser on the wall behind you.
Hello, could it be? Oh, yeah, Crystal Star. Advantage Bowser.
At last, we found one, and now we'll make it ours.
Freeze, chumps. Who's there? Don't tell me you don't know the famous Rock Hawk. You little punk weasel, you forgot these muscles? You forgot this hugeness? Don't ask me how, but you cleared my secret training facility. Not too shabby.
He's giving me all my energy, I don't know why.
I even imported some super freaks to up the difficulty level. You're good. Of course, good don't count for squatting this biz, babe. My champ belt is mine. Oh, look! What an adorable little weakling! Hi, fella!
They both kind of have the same voice.
Weak. Wait. What? Well, tell me something.
You ever something? Do this?
Do this?
Oh! Pain! If I hear someone while trying to steal something important, I take it and run, not approach them and talk, not saying I'm a stealing game look from them.
Ouch.
Aw, you're sleeping. I knew you were a weakling. The Crystal Star?
Eek, it's split in two. Oh, no. Wait, hold the phone. My mighty Lord Bowser, this is just glass. It's a flim-flam, a fake.
What are you saying? Use words I know.
You, want the real one? The great, Gonzales has it. Oh, my aching hair. Feel the rock.
I don't know anybody named Gonzales. Stop speaking in riddles, you chicken nugget. Crud. Who do I have to flatten to get a crystal star? Who? Who?
Right.
Mario, that sounds like an email from Princess Peach.
Does he have a special ringtone for Princess Peach? If so, that's really cute.
Mario, I now know where I'm being held. I'm on the moon, yes. The moon that floats out in space. And I've learned something even more horrifying. In order to resurrect the monster spirit, they need my...
The moon? Like, the one in space? Princess Peach is on the moon? I mean, that actually sounds pretty cool, but why is her email cut off?
Oh my gosh, you don't think something happened to her, do you?
Okay, we're going to... listen to Luigi's story next time.
Now we're gonna steal the moon!
but before I wrap it up for today, we're gonna gamble. Let's see if we won the lottery. I love Gru. Honestly, Despicable Me is such a fun movie.
Ooh, we're not lucky at all today.
Sorry, it's an unlucky day. Your ticket isn't a winner today. But every day brings a new chance, so try again, okay? Here's a consolation prize. Nice. Come again tomorrow.
Before, we gotta gamble. All
right. Yeah, I'm gonna go back here, I'm gonna save, and then that way, next time we can pick up with Luigi's story, we can go visit the professor, we can go to the door, etc., etc. But yeah, this seems like a good place to leave it. 3-hour stream, pretty good, pretty good. We had a couple of, like, I usually try to aim for 2.5 hours, so we had quite a few nice long streams this week. Next week I'm gonna try and take it a little easier just to rest and recuperate. I'm also worried that I have like the start of a cold that I'm fighting off. Not the 2 saves, I just do it out of habit, honestly. Cause you know, if you never double save, then that's the time that you're just gonna forget to save altogether. But yeah, next week I'm gonna take a little bit easier. We'll continue the playthrough of Paper Mario, but I'll post my schedule when I know exactly what I'm doing. And I think I'm gonna also try and keep up like posting on my Twitch story and my Instagram story on like the days that I'm actually going live and roughly the time. Cause I think that's just been working, I guess. I don't know why I didn't always do that, but it just seemed like a good idea. Anyway, I'll probably, if the Northern Lights are still out there, I'll take some pictures and post them on my Instagram. I don't think my camera is gonna pick it up in a video format, so I don't really think there's a point in live streaming it, but I need to go fast, the lights, they break dancing, yeah, exactly. So I'll post pictures on Instagram, if my phone's able to capture them. Hopefully they're still bright and glowing. I mean, it's only been like 15 minutes, so I think we should be good. Anyways, thanks so much for tuning in today. I will see you whenever I see you next. And remember to drink some water, stay hydrated. And yeah, take care. Bum, 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 bum. I'm liking the pictures, I'm glad. yeah, I didn't use my Instagram much before, but I'm glad that I'm using it again. Anyways, bye. I will see you whenever I see you next. Now burn!